Morning, church.
Morning.
I'm emotionally overwhelmed by what happened. My name is Ndinai. I have been practicing as a nursing officer for the past. So in 2016, I lost my father due to cancer of the liver. And then in June 2016, my doctors discovered that I have a liver condition. They ran all the tests and discovered that I have something that is commonly called a fatty liver. It was bulky and very fatty. And my liver function tests were a bit abnormal, very abnormal. So I was started on treatment to try to treat the liver. One thing that you should know about the liver is that actually there is no treatment for the liver. The only treatment that is available for the liver is to what we medically say, do a liver rest. Liver rest means you don't have to take any medication. You have to stop taking proteins, a lot of proteins and everything, so that the liver can rest and heal itself. So I've been having that condition since 2016. Then I'll go for my annual checkups to check what, how is the liver going. Then mid-May this year, around the 18th, I went for my checkup again. And this time around, the results came back and they were very bad. The doctor told me, with this condition, we don't know what to say. Because almost everything was elevated. Some of the readings were as high as 3 times. And I've been in this field, the medical field. I've seen patients with the same blood results that I had, and most of them never made it. Let me say all of them. So now the doctor was even suspecting that I might not just be having a fatty liver, but even having a liver infection. So she suggested that I should come for checkup after 2 weeks to run further tests. And then that's when I started to text all my family members that, guys, I have a problem here. My liver is not coping. Bo Magwere, who happened to be church members here, are my blood cousins. I also sent them the results. They were really bad. Then Magwere advised me to come for counseling here. She arranged and organized for me to come for a counseling session here. Initially, when I left my house, I thought the whole reason of me coming here for counseling was just to help me cope with my condition. And bear in mind that I'm also a counselor. I've done individual counseling. So I just came here with my head down because I had lost hope. I had even started preparing for my own death. I know what I wouldn't make it. I had all these fears. I would cry alone. I had all these worries. I wouldn't sleep. I didn't want to scare my family members. I didn't tell them the truth that the doctor is saying it's bad. So I came here, attended counseling session. For the first time, I felt like this counseling session is different from what we normally do at the local clinics. Yeah. Because now Muriti taught us the steps that you have to accept your situation, you have to forgive yourself, you have to reject all these negative thoughts, and far and above all, ask God to heal you. Then immediately after the counseling session, I went to Muruti's office and I told Muruti the truth that if there's anything that I fear most is death. I know this condition is going to take me down. Muruti talked to me, prayed with me. Then as he was praying, he asked God to give me a new liver. Something that medically, I know it's not possible. It's like, so is Muruti calling for a liver transplant in his office? And by the way, when I was with my doctor, we discussed those options of liver transplant. We don't have donors around. It's a problem. And I only know a few people who survived after liver transplant. So last week, on Wednesday, was it the 6th, I went for my checkup, the usual checkup, with my head down. When I left the counseling session, Muruti kept on saying, please bring your results for review so that I can see them. Bring your results. When I left his office, I was like, Kana Muruti is not a medical person. What does he want? And I remember leaving his office, and he was saying, please bring the results so that I can see them. So on Wednesday, I went for scan to see the radiographer. The very radiographer that I've been using all this time around. When she started scanning my body, the first question that she asked me is, who told you you have a liver condition? So I told her, I agree, you are the one who told me before that I have a bulky liver that is fatty. She said, no, this liver is normal. And now she even went further, checked the liver from the back, told me to take all these positions. She told me, there isn't even a bit of fat. This liver is very normal. Then I went to do my blood test, and the doctor told me to come for the results yesterday on Saturday. So now I was anxiously waiting for the results. I've seen the scan, the results, but is it possible? Maybe the lady who was doing the scan missed something. And the extraordinary happened. I got my results back yesterday. My liver is perfect. For the first time since 2016, my liver is very normal. Very normal. If I can tell you about how much I spend on medical bills from 2016, I try to go for the best doctors that you can think of. Paying, doing blood tests. There was another time when I was told that I shouldn't take meat for 6 months. You can imagine that pain. And even when Muruti prayed for me, I was still doubtful to say, would really? And he even told me, I know you guys as medical personnel, you have your own thoughts, your own beliefs, but trust me, my God will do it for you.
Amen.
And here I am today as a nursing officer telling you that these things are possible.
Amen.
Very possible. I even failed to express how I slept last night. For the first time, slept like a baby. I had to wake up this morning preparing and running. I came to church running.
Amen.
I didn't even come. Normally my cousins will come and pick me up so that we can come and visit. But this time around, I just took a taxi and came to church alone. So I'm just standing here to encourage all of you, all of us. If you have a situation, a medical condition, that you think there's nothing. I had lost hope, remember what I said. And my worst fear was death. I knew that I was going. But today, everything has changed.
Amen.
I have a new chapter of life. Now I can start dreaming about everything. And I thank Muruti, and above all, I thank God for this miracle. I never thought this would happen to me.
Amen.
Thank you so much.